What's up guys, I'm Bassam Abu Jaber, fashion and beauty photographer. Today I want to show you how I edit this picture. So before we begin, if you like the video, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell button to not miss any video coming. So let's get started. Let's reset everything. First thing, I shot this at 5D Mark IV at 85mm, at ISO 100, at 1.8. And here first I changed my camera profile. I go to the camera matching and I choose too many good profile actually here. Faithful is good and standard is good. I go to the with standard. First thing, I lighten my image a little bit. I decrease the highlight and I open the shadow. And I decrease also the white little bit, and here in the clarity I put little bit clarity, and in dehaze I dehaze my image like +6, and then I go to the HSL. I put in HSL, I make the orange more red and the red more orange and the yellow also more orange. And the green, I make it about 90, the green, more green. And then the green I do in the saturation, I make the green 0. And I decrease also the yellow, and I decrease the orange, and I decrease also the red. In the luminance, I lighten a little bit the red, and I darken a little bit the orange, and also I lighten the yellow. So then I go to the split toning. I put in split toning like green in the highlight, and in the shadow I put like blue magenta, and here in the saturation I put 5, and here 6 or maybe 7, and this everything, this before and this after. So let's now jump to Photoshop and begin editing. So guys, first thing, I want to jump to the liquify. You can find it here, filter, liquify. I want to make the hair a little bit more volume with the hair. And the waist, I want to fix the waist a little bit. Something like this. So first thing, now I want to begin with the color grading. I got a new group. I got selective color. This time I want to begin with color grading before cleaning, and then I clean my image. In the yellow I put little bit cyan and little bit magenta and little bit yellow. Something like this. It's better not to copy my number, because every time I do it different. It's depend on your image. So, and I put little bit red in the shadow and the red, and little bit blue, and I lighten it little bit here, and in the black I put little bit cyan. And then I go to the color balance. First in the highlight I put little bit cyan and little bit yellow and little bit green, and in the shadow I put the opposite. Always you should put the opposite color in the shadow. I put little bit like magenta and one cyan and little bit green, little bit blue, something like this. This before and this after. So let's now get let's duplicate my layer and begin editing. Begin cleaning my image. Command J or Control J NPC. And then I go to the spot healing brush. Actually, in my image, I didn't like to clean too much. I prefer my image natural and realistic skin. So as you see, the spot healing brush very easy to use for beginner and for professional also, but for beginner it's easier. Something like this. I didn't want to remove all the hair. Actually, I use for editing Wacom tablet. It's better and easier and faster than the mouse. Actually, it's better for Dutch unburn. Very hard to Dutch unburn if you have a mouse, and tablet very easy to. And also, of course, for cleaning. Actually, the skin here is clean, not too much work. So, and always I prefer to keep it natural, not to edit too much. So that's it for spot healing brush. Now I want to begin with patch tool. Patch tool very easy to use. Also like spot, you can circle the bad skin and you replace it with good one. Actually, when you have full body picture, you didn't need to edit the skin too much. Actually, in the face you didn't need to edit too much, because you see it from this from too far away, so it didn't matter if you left some blemishes or some So guys, now I want to begin with Dutch unburn. I have two layer here for Dutch unburn, two curve, one down and one up. So let's begin. I get the brush, I put in 2%, the flow I put in 2%, the opacity is at 100, so in small brush I begin lighten the blemish, actually not the blemish, the blotchy skin. Okay, I use soft brush for this technique. So first I zoom out like this to see where I should fix. As you see here I have too many blotchy skin. So then I zoom in. Actually, if you want to do it perfect, you should zoom in like this and you fix all this. As you see, blotchy skin, the small blotchy skin, you should fix it all if you want to do the picture perfect. But you didn't need for this type of picture, but for close-up or beauty you should lighten all this blotchy skin. As you see, you can lighten it all to get good result. Let's show you before and after. Before after not huge different, but at the end you see huge different. But for this picture I didn't need like this to do it. I want to zoom out a little bit and work fast. This technique for this kind of picture take about 20 minutes to 30 minutes maximum. In this picture I try to do it at 15, maybe at 10, because I prefer it not perfect. For Dutch amber you should practice actually, because when you begin with Dutch amber you didn't know what you're doing, so you should practice and practice, and at the end you will be good. You should practice every day and get a picture and try to fix the skin with Dutch amber. Actually, the idea here is to put light in the blotchy skin. You should lighten the blotchy skin actually. And make sure always to put your brush in white, because if you put in black the brush didn't work. So guys, we finished Dutch amber and cleaning and everything. So let's show you the Dutch amber. This is the first layer, this before, after. Actually this is the first one, this is the cleaning, before, after. And this is the contouring, and I make like halo around the model. And this for the eyes. I lighten a little bit the eyes. And this all together, everything, this before and this after. Let's show you now everything together from start to finish. This is before and this after. Before, after. I hope you like it guys. If you like it, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell button to don't miss any video coming. And see you on the next video.